KS Heating and Air, the team ensuring your comfort.
It's the Weather Xtreme video. This is the afternoon edition. This is for Tuesday, the 7th of January. I'm James Spann. Alabama's weather dry through Thursday. Then we have the dual threat of flooding and severe storms Friday and Saturday. The severe weather day would be Saturday. Many questions. Let's see if we can find some answers. We'll start with the upper air look across the country. Troughing coming through the eastern states that brought some light rain to Alabama early this morning when you were sleeping between midnight and 6 a.m. And that is bringing snow to parts of the middle Atlantic coast region this afternoon. But in the wake of that, we have a very dry air mass, nothing but blue sky and sunshine. This afternoon, temperatures are mostly in the 50s. We'll drop down to near the freezing mark tomorrow morning with a clear sky. Bitterly cold air nosing down into parts of North Dakota and Minnesota, but the upper air winds will not allow that to come down this way. In fact, we'll be in the 70s here by Friday. There's the watch warning map. Winter weather advisories around the Washington, D.C. area this afternoon. Also a few scattered issues back in the northwest. Convective outlook today and tonight. Maybe some thunder for the northern Pacific coast. Otherwise, things are quiet. Things start to shake and bake on Friday, day four. We have a risk of severe storms west of the state, parts of Texas, Oklahoma, Louisiana, Arkansas. The higher 30% ring around the Arklatex region. Then on day five, which is Saturday, all of the deep south with a severe weather risk. And again, that 30% circle would represent an enhanced risk. But understand, this will change. It's just too early to be really specific on the magnitude of this and the timing. Just be aware that Saturday looks like an active severe weather day. And we'll talk about what we know now in just a second with modeling. And wet, yeah, a lot of rain for the east in this pattern. This is for the next 7 days. This is suggesting the northern third of the state could see 4 to 6 inches. About 2 inches for central Alabama, 1 to 2 inches in southeast Alabama. Very wet pattern here. So let's look at the GFS. This is the 12Z run, valid tomorrow afternoon at 3. Trough in the northwest, ridging here, and a beautiful day tomorrow. We start the day around freezing. The high will be in the low 60s, a nice warm-up. Thursday, the winds turn to the south. The Gulf begins to open up, but we stay dry. We're expecting mid-60s with a partly sunny sky. Then on Friday, we'll have the chance of rain at times, maybe some thunder. Don't expect any severe weather here. We'll be up in the low to mid-70s, very mild. The risk of severe storms well to the west of the state, basically along and east of Interstate 35 over parts of Texas, Oklahoma, and Arkansas, Louisiana. Now, this is Saturday. The trough lifts out going negative tilt. Very good dynamic support. This is the GFS at the surface. It's faster. This is the European. It's slower and deeper. And this is probably closer to the truth. We note back in the cold air, snow likely for places like Kansas City and Wichita, maybe even Tulsa, up to Chicago. They could have icy conditions there, but we're in the warm sector. It's a deep low under 1,000 millibars over southern Illinois, very favorable for severe weather. Unstable air surges northward. Instability values exceed 1,000 joules per kilogram over South Alabama. Birmingham showing near over 500 joules. And again, that's not a big number for April, but anytime you see numbers like that in January, certainly supportive of severe weather. And this is the lightning flash density product off the European. No doubt there'll be some very strong convection and heavy rain. But again, we've talked about this all week. Once we get within 60 hours, we get within the time frame of the convection allowing models, the CAMs, we'll have a much better idea of the magnitude, the timing, and the mesoscale features that really determine the severity of this thing. But if you watch these videos, you're going to get the warnings, but just let your friends and neighbors know that Saturday will be a severe weather day. Be sure they can hear warnings. They have a plan. They know what they're going to do if they come under a tornado warning polygon. It could be a significant severe weather day, but again, we're not ready to, you know, call it that way yet. We'll get within that 60-hour window by Wednesday night and Thursday. Sunday, that feature's on by. Sunday should be dry. No really cold air behind it. We'll still be in the 60s. And then Monday, the surface boundary lifts north as a warm front, and more rain moves in here, like we really need that. Probably no severe weather. Temperature should be in the low 60s. And this is a week from today, Tuesday the 14th, troughing in the west, ridging in the east. And again, that suggests maybe some lingering rain on Tuesday, especially during the morning. Now, let's go out to Wednesday night of next week, the night of the 15th, the GFS depicting another front with more rain and really cold air coming in behind that thing. That's a 1,053 millibar high that's over northeast Montana. And then this is Friday of next week, the 17th. The flow goes zonal and we're dry, and the GFS tries to develop a nasty icing mess over much of Texas, but the European says no. So again, this is 10 days out, and this is out there in voodoo country, and this will change again, but that looks pretty much quiet for Alabama. This is the rain for Birmingham off the European Ensemble. How about 6 inches? Wow, that's the mean for the next 15 days. Very wet pattern. And if you're looking for Arctic air, nope. The AO stays positive. The numbers here are more like spring. Many days highs in the 60s. We could see 70s on a couple of days, maybe Friday and Saturday. Lows many nights in the 40s and 50s. And this is the CPC outlook for the 15th through the 21st. Very cold in the west and up north. Very mild for the east and down here in the southeastern states. But understand, winter's just a few weeks old. We got a lot of time to go for a pattern change here. That's it for the Weather Xtreme video this afternoon. We'll have notes in the blog. The next video here by 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. You can catch us this evening on ABC 3340 News at 4, 5, 6, and 10 o'clock. Thanks for watching. Have a great evening and God bless.
Never wait for hot water again with a tankless water heater from Plumbing Experts. Tankless water heaters are easy, convenient, and now more affordable with a no-interest financing for up to 18 months. Stop with the cold showers and wasted water and call Plumbing Experts today.